Good afternoon, everyone. Can you hear me all right? Yeah? Okay. I'm not sure I'm addressing this topic in the way that I'm supposed to, so I'm not. But we all do the best we can, so anyway. We all know that the year 2025 is important. Those of us who study the Tibetans' work, we know that there, each 25th year of every century, there's a conclave within the spiritual hierarchy of the planet wherein important decisions are made, and this one will be no different. We're told that we know that we're preparing for the externalization and that this conclave will take stock of humanity's progress in preparing for those great events, and therefore the timing of the externalization will, we're told, be decided. And also, 2025 spells the end of this 60-year period of the stage of the forerunner, which is the stage of the new group of world servers, time to help prepare human consciousness for these events. But 2025 is also perhaps less well known for the fact that we're told that in the cycles of the various seven rays, that we will have the influx of a new ray energy, that of the fourth ray. And this third point is the one that I'm going to say a few thoughts about today. When the rays come into cyclic manifestation and when they go out of cyclic manifestation, it's said to be because the great musician of the universe is moving the keys and sounding another note and bringing about another turning of the great wheel. So if we think of it from the macrocosmic level, it's really very simple and a very beautiful moment. An array brings with it, when it cycles in, all things that are attuned to it. It brings in the zodiacal and planetary influences associated with it. It brings in the colors and sounds associated with that ray. It brings in the flora and fauna that resonate with it. It also brings in individuals who are coming forth along that ray line. And the fourth ray is particularly important for humanity, we're told, because the fourth ray is said to govern the soul of that great entity, humanity. So on a spiritual level, it would seem that the incoming of the fourth ray would have a very profound effect on the soul of our kingdom, the fourth kingdom. We're also the fourth planet in the solar system. As has been mentioned, we know that we're passing through a great time of initiation on our planetary life, initiation human and solar. So it's not just the great life that ensouls our planet that's passing through an initiatory process, but it's individuals here and there who are taking themselves in hand, and the opportunity for initiation is therefore held out to us. The fourth ray is a vehicle for the inpouring of illumination, and so it aids in this process of initiation. The clear, cold light of Bodhi is related to the fourth ray and will be an instrumental factor in contributing to this initiatory effect. The fourth ray is said to be the refiner, the producer of perfection within the form. It's related to the temple of God, and it's that which houses the light. Of this ray, it is said, sound and the soundless one meet in an infinite point of peace. Time and the timeless one negate the thoughts of men. It's the ray of the seeker, the searcher, the sensitive reflector of beauty. This ray energy brings these gifts to humanity, not only to those who function on this ray, but to all seekers of truth. The fourth ray facilitates the inner work of bridge building. Ancient peoples used myth, legend, astrology, painting, rituals, and drama to convey spiritual truth. Today, the focus is more upon words, but as the fourth ray comes into manifestation, we can probably expect a renaissance in the arts, as the influence combines with that of the seventh ray to produce the artist in excelsis. Today, the arts quite often stimulate the lower chakras, but as we move forward, we will increasingly see artists coming forward whose vehicles will be of such a caliber that they will be able to touch increasingly subtle vibrations, tapping into archetypes of beauty that are awaiting precipitation. Art ideally should provide the viewer with a portal into the higher realms, a type of transportative and decidedly spiritual experience. The fourth ray harmonizes the harshness in our world, fosters right relationships, perhaps through initial conflict, and eventually aids humanity to turn towards peaceful solutions to world problems and towards the cultivation of goodwill. We also know the fourth ray is the linking agent. It links the three higher rays, the first three rays of aspect, with the three lower rays of attribute. And this parallels the role of humanity as the linking agent between the kingdom of God and the three lower kingdoms. We have some understanding today of what it's like to witness the outgoing of a ray energy, because as we know, we're passing through the time of the withdrawal of the sixth ray of devotion. We can see that this ray energy, as it passes out, crystallizes, and the lower aspects of the energy are more prevalent, such as fundamentalism, which we see on all sides. But we don't have a familiarity, in this lifetime at least, of the influx of a ray energy and what it might cause for our world. So I found it interesting yesterday that Steve was speaking about the Age of Enlightenment, because when I looked back at the time when the seventh ray came into manifestation, it coincided with this Age of Enlightenment. So there was a real thrust and a real push and change in our planetary life with the influx of that ray that came in 1675. So we perhaps can expect a real shift when this fourth ray comes in. When we talk about the incoming of the fourth ray, it should be noted that we're talking about the incoming in a minor cycle of that ray. Because in the major cycle of the fourth ray, it has been in effect for several thousand years already. So the Tibetan is talking about the influx of a minor cycle. The major cycle, we're told, will continue for another 40,000 years. So he seems to indicate that when a ray energy comes in a minor cycle, it has a particular importance for humanity. It seems that we can't really tap into the subtleties of the major ray cycles. So we're talking here about minor cycles. So another idea related to the fourth ray, which was given to me in the title of this talk, was the perceiver on the way. This is the first name of the ray, fourth ray lord that the Tibetan gives us. So we would assume that this has something quite important to do with the quality of the fourth ray. So we would say, have to hypothesize that through the influence of this ray energy, we will become better perceivers, better observers, and therefore more in touch with our soul, because the soul is the undying one. The soul is the observer and the perceiver. So perhaps under this influence, we will be better able to see beneath the glamour of our times, which we're told and we know from living in this world is very thick. The glamour covering the astral plane and the illusion governing the mental plane is very thick at this time as we prepare for the reappearance. And so it is the influx of this fourth ray energy which is enabling us to see more clearly. through the fogs and mists. And particularly for disciples in the world today, this energy will help us perfect the alignment process. Okay. And the Tibetan gives us a beautiful phrase related to this dissipation of glamour when he says, "Disillusioned and deglamored, humanity awaits the coming revelation." So this disillusionment, which we see all around us and perhaps feel within ourselves, and this deglamorization, which might tend to bring about negative effects in consciousness at times, is actually part of the plan, and it's a good thing because we're waking up. Humanity holds a pivotal role in our planetary life. Our destiny, we're told, is to become the planetary light bearer. And it's through the group of world servers that this becomes possible of realization. The new group is governed by the sign Taurus and by the planet Mercury, both of which are fourth ray in nature. So we can hypothesize that the incoming of this fourth ray of harmony through conflict will have a very potent effect within the new group, aiding them in the process of preparing for the reappearance. The fourth ray will surely return to us the beauty of the daily life, the beauty of the small things, and the joy of the present moment, as opposed to the fragmentation, the noisiness, and the disharmony of so much of contemporary life. But the fourth ray is also the ray of contrasts, of highs and lows, of rushing forward with daring and intensity of feeling, but also of cowardice and paralysis. Therefore, when this influence is strong, it can be difficult to maintain the emotional balance and poise, which is so necessary to traverse the spiritual path. The fourth ray is the ray of poetry. And many of our poets were surely conditioned strongly by the joy and the curse of this ray influence. That's related not only to harmony, but also to crisis. The poet finds significance in the small things in life and seizes them and at times immortalizes them. Here's a portion of an ode to the nightingale by the heartfelt poet John Keats, which shows you some of the intense feelings of the fourth ray person. So he speaks of a nightingale. "Fade far away, dissolve and quite forget what thou amongst the leaves hast never known, the weariness, the fever, and the fret here where men sit and hear each other groan, where palsy shakes a few sad last gray hairs, where youth grows pale and specter thin and dies, where but to think is to be full of sorrow and leaden-eyed despair, where beauty cannot keep her lustrous eyes or new love pine at them beyond tomorrow." But then he goes on with a little more of an uplifting feeling as the nightingale flies away. "Adieu, adieu, the plaintive anthem fades, past the near meadows, over the still stream, up the hillside, and now 'tis buried deep in the next valley glades. Was it a vision or a waking dream? Fled is that music, do I wake or sleep?" The goal of the fourth ray is to create, but steadily the emanating source of those creations shifts and eventually arrives at the release of the hidden splendor. We're told, "Let the outer glory pass away and the beauty of the inner light reveal the one. Let dissonance give place to harmony. And from the center of the hidden light, let the soul speak. Let the word roll forth. beauty and glory veil me not. I stand revealed. I am. As the world teacher moves outward onto the physical plane, it's said that the present emotional chaos will be reoriented and a new calm will descend through the waters of the astral etheric planes. This process will be aided by the gifts of the fourth ray. And it's said of this time, which you all know this passage, then will the sons of men respond. Then will a newer light shine forth into the dismal, weary veil of earth. Then will new life course through the veins of men, and then will their vision compass all the ways of what may be. So peace will come again on earth, but a peace unlike aught known before. Then will the will to good flower forth as understanding, and understanding blossom as goodwill in men.